If you really want to be successful, you're going to have to make sure that you are able to fight off any temptation to give up or be lazy, whatever the case may be, because it will happen. There are going to be days where you wake up and don't feel like trying to do anything challenging or to grow or to push yourself to the limit so that you become better next day. You're going to wake up and feel just sluggish and tired and unmotivated, and that will happen. But you need to make sure that you are focused on the right things and focused on your future goals. And you need to have the willpower to be able to push through that wall of laziness or the wall of unrest and just be able to figure out a way to constantly work on your goals every single day.
These experiences, and the more you experience, the more you have to offer. The more, right? I mean, the more empathy you have, the more you can offer to your kids,
yes.
The more you can offer to your team, your employees. Yep. And so I have really made it in you have to work on this shit. As you get older, creating newness is hard. So I'm just in action mode. I'm almost operating like I'm manic. Yeah. Because there's so much I want to do and I love life so much. I don't want to miss it. I don't want to miss it because I'm lazy. Yeah. It's not the right time. I don't have enough experience. And it has nothing to do with money. When they said no, you kept going because you wanted it. Mm. If you really want to change, you will change. If my wife said to me, let's go get better. Let's go see a therapist. Okay. And I didn't really want to go. I'm going because of her. It's not going to work. If I want to go to the therapy, it's because genuinely I want our relationship, because why the hell would I want to live in chaos? To get better, it's going to get better. So my advice would be like, if you really want it, you will figure it out. But if you're just telling yourself you want it because like you think you do, it's not going to happen.
No matter how challenging it may be, you can possibly be stuck in a rut and be tired of working on your goals, but you need to know that once you reach the pinnacle of success that you've strived for every day, all that hard work and time and energy exfoliated into your project will be worth it 110% guaranteed. A great way to stay motivated is by constantly looking at your goals and writing them down as frequently as possible so they're always in your mind, and then imagine and plan out what you're going to do once you become successful so that you have something to look forward to in a plan of attack so that your dreams no longer are dreams, but you've produced them into a plan for your life, and you will follow that plan with everything that you have in an unrelentless force of motivation.
No, I just realized that I'm an adrenaline junkie. I love newness. I love challenges. I mean, that's what makes me feel most alive. And I discovered that early on when I was trying to get a record deal and just getting rejection. And I had no connections. My dad owned the plumbing supply house in Long Island where I grew up, and we weren't connected to the music world. And I just loved the thrill of trying to do what everyone said I couldn't do. There's no way you could, you know, and all my roommates in college were writing their resumes and sending it out to all the companies. They're like, why aren't you writing your resume? We're all like typing our resume. Why aren't you working on it? I'm like, because I'm going to get a record deal. When they said, no, you can't, it just fueled me more to want to go out and get it. You know already what you're going to miss. You're going to miss your family and your kids and your friends and some of the comforts. You know, I didn't want to give away some of the comforts that I had. But you also realize that how much, at least I did, in my daily life, how much time I spend and worry I spend on things that are irrelevant. And when I released that, I got so insanely creative and had so much energy. Because like thoughts, worry, all that, it's exhausting.
But we all make mistakes and we all fall off the wagon. You know, one thing that I've done that's really helped me is instead of thinking of in terms of day to day, I think of things weekly. Let me give you an example. Instead of thinking like, okay, I'm gonna run 5 miles every day this week. I'm gonna write 10 pages of my book every single day this week. I'm gonna sit down, I'm gonna write 10 pages. Inevitably, things happen. Your kids get hurt, you have to go to the doctor, an appointment happens, and like you miss days. So I started looking at things weekly. I'm gonna run 35 miles this week. I'm gonna write 50 pages this week. So it gives, we're human. It allows for human error. And I can now make it up. If I miss a day, it's not the end of the world. If I tell myself I'm gonna run every day and I miss a day, I'm like, I lost. You know, I didn't succeed, I failed. And if I give myself that leeway, because I didn't run yesterday or today, I do have a weekly goal, I'm just gonna pick it up the next 2 or 3 days. So we play basketball, we work out, or usually we, you know, we do something together. And then when they go to school, I work out. Actually, I work from 8 to, this is my exact day. Kids 6:30 to 8, I work from 8 to 10, I work out from 10 to 1, I work from 1 to 4, and then I shut it down.
When your brain says you're done, you're only 40% done. So very often we stop because our brain is a defense mechanism, doesn't want us to get hurt. It sends a signal to us, taps us and says, hey man, stop running.
you're running too fast. I'm breathing. Like, stop. And we do. We listen. We are in tune with our body. We listen. But the real gold and magic and the real, like, what are your limitations go well beyond what you think you can do. I feel like it gives me an edge. It probably is just my own little thing. But if I walk in and you're sitting there and I'm like, I'm not leaving. I'm gonna walk out before you walk out? What is that? No way. So very often I'll just, no one in the sun will even know I'm playing again. There could be multiple people. I'm like, oh, he's here, okay. He's gotta go before I go. Take a deep breath and I wait. And then when they all finally clear out, I just kind of whisper to myself, you lose, and that's it. And I feel like it just gives me like I'm always looking for something to build on. And I feel like a lot of being an entrepreneur, a lot of things that happen in my life, when you have edge is an advantage, edge could be a little swagger. It's something you can just take with you anywhere. It could just be a simple thing like patience. You could be in traffic. I mean, it comes into play all the time. I'm just trying to get better and build, and that's one of many games that I play.
Thank you all so much for watching this video. If you haven't already, please go ahead and like the video, subscribe to the channel if you're new, and let us know what you thought down in the comment section below.